Welcome to the wonderful Cambrian period of Earth, which gave us masterpieces of character designs like this, and also this. However, this video will be about the Anomalocaris, so let's delve deeper into the intriguing world of Anomalocaris and the ancient seas it ruled over 530 million years ago during the Cambrian explosion. Picture a primordial ocean teeming with bizarre creatures, where Anomalocaris, dubbed the unusual shrimp, reigned supreme. Fossils unearthed from the Burgess Shale in Canada, along with findings in China, Greenland, Australia, and Utah, paint a vivid picture of the widespread presence of this enigmatic giant. At an impressive 6 feet in length, Anomalocaris stood as the undisputed heavyweight champion among the Burgess Shale fossils, dwarfing its contemporaries. To unravel the mysteries of this ancient predator, scientists have meticulously studied fossilized body parts and complete specimens, offering glimpses into its unique locomotion and predatory tactics. The creature's optical prowess was a key to its success. With stalked compound eyes boasting thousands of lenses, providing Anomalocaris with unparalleled sharp vision. Imagine the seascape through its lens, a world illuminated in vivid detail. This visual acuity, combined with a presumed undulating swimming motion, endowed Anomalocaris with remarkable speed, making it an agile and efficient hunter. The moment of confrontation with its prey showcased another extraordinary adaptation, front limbs armed with sharp spikes on each segment. This lethal weaponry, coupled with its keen vision and swift movement, transformed Anomalocaris into a fearsome predator, patrolling the Cambrian seas with unmatched prowess. Now, let's turn our attention to the creature's mouth, a topic that sparks lively debate among paleontologists. Composed of 32 overlapping plates, Anomalocaris's mouth has spurred speculation about its dietary habits. Some scientists propose that this complex structure allowed the creature to crush prey, citing bite-like marks in trilobites as evidence. However, Dr. Whitey Hagedorn challenges this notion, suggesting that Anomalocaris's mouth and teeth were too soft for such a feat. The absence of wear and tear on the fossilized plates and tips adds a layer of mystery to this ancient enigma, highlighting the inherent challenges of interpreting behaviors from half a billion years ago. What do you think? I personally believe that the Anomalocaris was the apex predator of the Cambrian period, and it hunted animals. Tell me your thoughts in the comments below. Thank you for watching.